Hello friends, welcome back to the channel. My name is Big Winter and today I'm going to talk you through the rumored and confirmed changes for Season 16 of Apex Legends and why you, as a returning player, a concurrent player, or a new player, you should be playing Apex Legends this season. Apex is evolving and there are some huge changes coming with this particular update. Just to put into perspective how massive of a change is happening this season, EA has put out two statements. Firstly, they have said that nothing is safe, and secondly, they have said Apex Chapter 2 is coming. The reason why I find this statement of Apex Chapter 2 is coming is so massive is if you look at something like Fortnite and how massive of a change happened in Season 2 and how much it changed the dynamic and everything with the licensing and everything they added to the game, that is how big of an update we are talking with Season 16. I actually just finished streaming Apex about an hour ago. I stream on twitch.tv/bigwinter. I stream every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday at the moment. I would love for you to come hang out with me. Wednesday are my Apex days and we start at 1 PM UK time. But with that out of the way, let's get straight into the video, starting with the confirmed changes for Season 16. Firstly, it has been confirmed that Season 16 will drop on the 14th of February at 10 AM Pacific time. As of this recording right now, I literally just went and watched the gameplay trailer and it is looking extremely saucy. Go check it out if you haven't seen it already. It confirms a lot of the changes that I'm talking about in this video. Secondly, I'll get into the big negatives of this particular update. They have confirmed that Ballistic, the new legend, is not coming until Season 17. They have confirmed that cross progression across platforms is not coming as of yet. And they have confirmed that 120 FPS for next gen consoles is also not coming in Season 16, which is a big bummer. The first new game changing feature that they are adding to the game is how friendly it is going to be for new players, which is why I recommend getting into the game in Season 16 if you haven't done already. This is because of two major reworks that they are adding into the game. Firstly, they are updating the firing range to allow you to customize the bot layout a little bit more. It will allow you to have strafing targets and it will help a lot with in-game aim. They are also adding some orientation into the game. So if you've ever played a game like Fortnite in the last few years, you'll notice that your first few games in your account are primarily loaded with bot accounts to get you used to the style of playing the game and getting comfortable with the movement mechanics. If you've played the game at all over the last couple of years, you will know that the unranked side of the game is incredibly brutal. You will get new players getting paired with top 500 players, preds, with their 4k damage and 20 kill banners. That is not fair, and that looks to be changing with these orientation matches. Additionally, a number of new game modes have been confirmed. Team Deathmatch will come straight in on February the 14th for the first 3 weeks. As far as I am aware, it is going to be a 6v6 best of three set of matches, and that is going to be a nice refreshing change of pace as opposed to the split battle royale and arenas, which nobody really plays except me. After those first 3 weeks are up, that TDM is going to be replaced by the mixtape playlist, which includes TDM, Gun Run, and Control. Apex's worst kept secret, the Nemesis Energy Burst Rifle, is coming into the game into the care package in Season 16. This gun was leaked as far back as Newcastle and the Broken Moon leaks well over a year ago at this point. With Season 16, another collection event is coming. This time it is going to be themed around the anniversary side of things. There were a few skins highlighted within the gameplay trailer, but nothing has been confirmed on EA's side just yet. The ranked side of Battle Royale also looks to be getting some fairly significant changes. Typically, it will be one map on one split and another map on the second split. This time, the maps are going to be rotating every 24 hours to get a bit more variety into the ranked playlist. The map rotation will be Broken Moon, Storm Point, and World's Edge. World's Edge rumored to be having balloons and carnival party themed decorations around Fragment City. But the biggest and by far the most huge change to the game since release and the addition of ranked playlists is the class system. These have been confirmed to be Assault, Recon, Skirmisher, Control, and Support. In Assault, we've got Ashe, Bangalore, Mad Maggie, Fuse, and Revenant. These will focus mainly on straight combat and gunplay. In the gameplay trailer, you could see the Assault bins, which is a new type of bin that only the Assault class can open. In Skirmisher, we have Octane, Pathfinder, Mirage, Wraith, Horizon, and Valkyrie, primarily the movement legend, focusing on a hit and run type tactic. The passive has not yet been completely confirmed, but they will be able to see what is coming down in the care packages. For instance, you could see a Kraber in the drop before it hits the ground. In Recon, you've got Bloodhound, Seer, Crypto, and Vantage. Their role is definitely going to be intel gathering and the classic wallhack abilities. Within the gameplay trailer, you can see that when they scan a beacon, it will reveal enemy team locations. In Controller class, you've got Watson, Rampart, Caustic, and Catalyst. It was somewhat vague within the gameplay trailer, but it looks as though their passive is going to reveal the next ring location, although that has not been confirmed yet. And finally, in support, you have got Lifeline, Lobo, Gibraltar, and Newcastle. They will be focused on keeping the team alive and well stocked with ammunition and loot. Additionally, in the gameplay trailer, you saw that they were able to craft dead teammates' banners. And this is a massive change to the game, and a much needed change to the game, I find. With the confirmed leaks out of the way, I think it's time we take a look at the rumored changes. For instance, there are a number of nerfs and buffs to a few legends, but nothing has been confirmed by EA. Valkyrie will no longer be able to scan enemies while skydiving. A big change is coming to Bloodhound, most likely, in that when they scan in their ultimate or their tactical abilities, they will get a static freeze frame of the enemy as opposed to a live movement system that they're used to. The Lifeline rework is not being confirmed at this stage. It is either 2x faster gathering the ultimate or 2x faster with the ultimate coming to the ground with the care package. Either way, not a massive change for Lifeline, unfortunately. Sorry, Lifeline mains. So as it stands, when Mirage reses a teammate, both him and the teammate are cloaked during the res, but the second the res is over, both teammates are visible. In Season 16, it is rumored that after the res, the downed teammate will remain cloaked for a short while, just long enough to get to cover, bat up, or escape if they need to. We have a number of the pros and streamers who were able to playtest Season 16 say that Wraith is going to be extremely strong this season, but from what we can tell from the leaks, it's likely that her ultimate is going to be extended range-wise by about 50%, so Portal A to B will be 1.5 times longer. And Seer is supposed to be getting a much-needed rework, but the details on that have not been finalized yet, and I wasn't able to find anything concrete. Additionally, it looks like the leaks on the recolor of Wraith's heirloom, the Kunai, may be coming in Season 16. I'm a little disappointed on this, to be honest with you. I was hoping that in Season 16 we would be getting another new heirloom for one of the newer characters. For instance, I play Vantage quite a lot. I would love for the heirlooms to catch up to her, but unfortunately it looks like EA are stuck in their roots of trying to monetize as much as they can season by season. And finally, it looks like there are going to be a number of changes with the weapons in Season 16. Firstly, sorry to all of you R301 mains. I love the gun myself, but it looks like per bullet is going from 14 to 13 damage. Additionally, it looks like assault rifles are getting a flat nerf in their hipfire spread to make things like assault rifles, shotguns, and pistols more viable in Season 16. The Vault SMG and the Longbow DMR are going into the Crafter. The Hemlock is being buffed and moved into the Supply Drop, and the Rampage is returning to the Floor Loot. And that just about wraps it up for today's Season 16. Summary, a bit of a tongue twister there. I really do hope you found it helpful and you're as excited as I am. If you did find it helpful or you are enjoying the content, please do consider liking, subscribing, and hitting that bell notification to be notified when I next post. I would love to have you come and join us on our other socials. I'll leave a link to everything in the description, the Discord, and the Twitch to come and join me live. But until the next time, enjoy the rest of your days, my friends, and I'll see you soon. Much love.